Hello interns and welcome to this presentation, Arid Lands Food Production and Traditional Ecological Knowledge. This is part of the internship program Farmers, Ranchers and Gatherers of the Southwest. Farmers, Ranchers and Gatherers of the Southwest is right now located in southern Arizona. Southern Arizona is a desert. Characteristic of this southern Arizona region is that we have an annual potential evapotranspiration that is higher than the annual rainfall. Due to the lack of water in the surface and low nitrogen content and low of organic matter content in our soil, we're talking about an infertile soil. So the orange area in the map that you can see right now to your right indicates all the parts in southern Arizona that are infertile. However, we managed to have food and grow enough food for the region currently and traditionally. According to the guide to Arizona agriculture and research done in this area in different fields, we know that there's evidence that food production happened long before Arizona was a state and the United States was a country. We have archaeological records that show that indigenous people grow gardens and sustain their families out of local food production. This traditional knowledge has passed from generation to generation through different means. We are so lucky that right now we still have the opportunity to learn firsthand this traditional ecological knowledge. This is a question for you. What do you think that happened that make food production available in this area? So I have two hints. First, the capability of manage water. And the second, the capability of transform soil, this arid soil, in productive soil. Let's reflect upon if we still use traditional ecological knowledge to survive in desert, as it is read here in this document. Food production in Arizona uses water the same way that uses land. Right after it says modern technology helps farmers and ranchers do what they need. And at the end, they make a reference to the excellent economic opportunities. And that's the part that makes me concerned. What do you think that the excellent economic opportunities have done with all our production system, industry, lifestyle, and so on? Think about in this very sensitive environment where we need water management and soil conversion to be able to produce food for the locals. What happened when you introduce concepts such as economic opportunities? The quick answer is we start facing overproduction. So instead of growing the variety of products, we start thinking on one agricultural product or two or few of them so we can grow more. And that's exactly what we are looking at in current times. We have the three pillars of Arizona's economy. We have food production, crops and livestock, manufacturing, and mining. What do you think? Which one is less damaging to the environment? So let's take a look at the impacts of this mass production of 10% of the global emissions come from agriculture. And obviously, it's not only the use of natural resources and the manipulation of land and the manipulation of the local resources towards mass production what is accounting for this 10%, but it's also the electricity and fossil fuels needed to run, for example, irrigation and distribution. What is the impact of these global greenhouse emissions? For example, the change of the patterns of rainfall. We have flooding in one side and then dry conditions in other side. Think about the atmosphere as a skin of our planet. Think about the impacts of any illness that you may have in a skin in any part of your body. Your entire body reacts. So that's exactly what is happening with the world, the entire world, due to climate change and this boosted emissions. For example, excessive nitrogen in some areas that erupt massive algae in the coast will impact the environment, wildlife, also human life. Small-scale food production is also a transformation of the environment. And so we do have active transformation of our land every time that we change the original conditions, that's for sure. However, mass production of food is tends to be more permanent. We have the uses of fertilizers and pesticides, an impressive rate of water consumption. So what we see at the end is an imbalance of the environmental conditions for native local life and habitats. Farmers, ranchers, and gatherers pay attention to sustainable farming because sustainable farming, ranching, and gathering tend to recreate natural processes that keeps balance between water and land, but also between consumption and demand. So what is that we are fighting for? We're fighting for recognition of sustainable practices and local production. Why? Because we have food deserts, many of them in the urban area where access to healthy and affordable food is limited. This is our enemy. This is what we are trying to fight against. The identification of food desert involves two major elements. One is low income and the second is low access. The food that is offered by fast food is not considered a healthy source of food. So the more we support local production, we can guarantee an independent, effective source of food to fight food deserts. So, how important is farmers, ranchers, and gatherers of the Southwest for Southern Arizona? A, we help combat climate change because first, we promote local farming, local ranching, and local gathering because they are closer to understand the natural cycles and then replicate those natural cycles. There is a respect for ecosystem and habitats because it defines urban boundary. The ownership of the land is a positive way to control sprawl. Preserve natural open spaces and habitat values, including water. Promotes local food production. That's exactly what we do. That's how important it is. Increase the consumption of fruits and vegetables, brings healthy food options, reduce transportation costs because it's local, because we are trying to promote these sustainable practices that are close to our locations, promotes employment creation, provides alternatives to response to higher and unstable food availability and prices. With the pandemic, some food options are not available in the grocery store, and the prices of the few products that are available and subject to demand, so sometimes the prices are higher. So what happens if we instead have local food producers offering and supplying us, then this market becomes a lot more stable, and also we are helping our neighbors. C, recognizes social and historical values. So first, we're promoting traditional knowledge, and that's one of our main goals, but also supports community cohesiveness. What is more supporting than knowing the people behind your food? Before we end this presentation, I just want to reflect upon one article that I read in The Guardian. This article was published in 2017 and is called If There's No Water, What's the Point? And it's a story. It's a photographic journal of female farmers in Arizona. And this is what it says. Farming does not respect personal boundaries, exhaustion levels, or breaking points. It is a lifestyle. I spill in over the beauty is an emergency. Sick animals, bolting crops, impeding freezes, equipment failures, last-minute orders, and all of the coinciding human actions and emotions. Farmers cannot ever fully leave the farm. Unlike the rest of the state, women make up the largest number of producers. So what it means in terms of, social cohesiveness. Most local farmers rely on storytelling to keep producing because it is estimated that 70% of the farmland will change hands in the next two decades. So this article concern about some of this knowledge being lost. Storytelling and mentoring is the way that the knowledge is transmitted right now. Our project, Farmers, Ranchers, and Gatherers, is specifically addressing that this local knowledge will be transferred to future generations, but not only of future generations of the management of the farms, but also future generations of consumers and promoters. It is urgent than ever to connect young farmers with Italian farmers in order to keep land in agricultural production. Why? Because again, as we saw through this presentation, I mean, our local food production is aware of the balance between water and land and the environmental conditions, but also the cultural conditions and needs. Now that you know that farmers, ranchers and gardeners is responding to local needs with evidence, ask yourself how important it is to be a knowledge seeker. So what is your role? What is your commitment right now?